Right, Des. This question's come from Geoff Lowe. In a 5-hour match on a typical snake lake, at what stage would you feed and then attack your margin swim?
Good question, that, Geoff. And I think that makes a big difference on a snake lake.
What, when you actually target the fish?
I think it depends, really. It depends on fish, F1s or carp. I think with F1s, I think you need to feed them more, especially with things like maggots and casters. I think you can feed it really early
because
the F1s, especially when the warmer weather's around, they will come in immediately. If you're on a snake lake with big carp, it can be really difficult. It might not come in right to the end. Normally on a snake lake, I would feed it casually at the start for maybe the first 3 hours, just littling often.
And you try to do that by hand?
Try and do it by hand, yeah. It depends on the venue and how good the fish is. Obviously, if it's quite hard fishing, you might have to go down sort of 10, 11 metres away from you. And I might just sort of every quarter of an hour, well, probably every sort of 30 to 45 minutes, bit of bait in a big pot, go down and prime it. You're just priming it
up. So, be regimented, come off your long line.
Yeah, even if I'm catching, that's, your next lines, basically. You might be feeding your top five and you're also priming your line up for later on. Because them fish, they do come in and out. You see carp come into the margins, you see them going out, and they always come back. You don't need to put poles and poles of bait. You just want to make sure that when you do go down there, these carp are sort of swimming around that area.
Yeah, that's a good tip, because quite often you see people, they're reluctant to come off feeding fish.
They are.
It's worthwhile doing it to prime this swim.
You've got to do it. Yeah. I always say to people, you're fishing this swim, where's your next move going to be?
Yeah.
It might be top five. Or it could be down the edge, or it could be
and
shallow.
And if you've not primed it and fed it correctly,
you might not catch there. So I would say, little and often at the start, go in, have a look. When you get to a situation in a match where you might have an hour and a half to go, you've been in there a couple of times, it's not happening. That's the time to say, right, I need to feed some bait here.
I'm going to concentrate on that.
Well, I've got to up me ante. I've got to put more bait in. Leave it, maybe not leave it so long. Put a big pot of bait in, go on your long line where you've been catching or short, 10 minutes, and then go back. You'll be amazed sometimes it's like that.
Instant.
They're instant. So you've got, I would say 2 hours in, if you've been in there and not caught, that's the time to sort of think, last hour and a half, I've got to start now priming. Sometimes you don't need to put loads of bait in. Sometimes they're just there, they're feeding, and you can clonk them. Sometimes you've got to put a volume of bait in to get the fish in your peg. Look to about 2 hours to go before you sort of start putting more bait in.
Other than an absolute red letter day, you'd be looking at really concentrating in the margins for the last 2 hours.
The last 2 hours, yeah. Yeah. You've got to keep your eye. Like I said, say to people, always look around. If you see someone go in the margin,
start to catch.
And they start to catch, that's the signal for you to think, I've got to go and have a look. It might not happen for you, but that's the time then you might have to make a decision to feed more bait to get the fish in your peg. Some days it doesn't happen at all, but that's, that's fishing.
And it can obviously just transform your
match. It can transfer your match. Matches I've been nowhere, and then you go down the margin, you win the match, or you get in the frame. So they're really, really, really important that you the margin line, you never forget about it, even in the winter.
So prime it well, and hopefully reap the rewards at the latter part of the match.
For more great videos like this, just subscribe to our YouTube channel.